Why are you laughing? Oh, hello, how to everyone in here. A rock's guitar strapped is twisted. So very twisted. Or aloha, everybody. We had to say aloha for a little bit, but now we're back with a hearty aloha. And I never get tired of it. So we should explain to new people, Jason has this theme song, it's a fabulous song, and in between the little Rob Benedict's singing, I typically will say something about Jason Manns in that given moment, and in this case it was Magnum P.I. Yo, then dressed like a narc, yo.
He's a mighty good man.
And then I said, never shaves.
He's mighty good man.
He prefers to take edible pot. That was it. The first was Magna P.I.O. dressed like a narco.
I feel like you kind of went off the rails at the end there a little bit.
When you said edible pot, some of the audience goes, whoa. Crossing the line.
Should have said, what second? Really shocked.
I guess I missed it, man. You were already on the narc thing, I guess.
On the narc thing, and also this whole weekend's all about letting out your inner Steve. And my inner Steve wanted to make a pot joke. And I'm just not, you know, I would have censored myself in any other town, but not in Hawaii, or as we call it, Steveton. And we're not doing it. We're releasing our Steves.
I have a question.
Okay.
Will y'all sing a song with me?
I don't know. Would Steve like us to sing a song? Steve says yes. I'm in.
In 17 hours, we can be a little bit of all the clouds. Over the rally, I can see my baby now.
I hear my lady call my name and let her know that she's the only one. If I die,
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Y'all mind if I keep these guys out of here for one more tune? They said no, Rob. I'm sorry. Rob and Billy and I have a little side band called the Station Breaks. We got together and wrote some stuff that wasn't really Loud and Swain, and it wasn't really Jason Mann's. So we said, let's just make a new thing. And we did. And this is one of those tunes.
Here it goes. And it's called Gone.
This is my Q&A. This is also my concert. So this is my quonsert. If you have any questions, thoughts, concerns, if you need life advice, I'll give you really terrible advice. But feel free to ask a question at either microphones. I'll sing some, and I'll talk some. I'm going to do the singing part right now.
Is come, the land is dark, and the moon is the only light we see. No, I won't be afraid, no, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stay by me. Oh, stay by me. Ooh, stay now, stay by me. If the sky we look upon tumble and fall, over mountains should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now, stand by me. If ever you're in trouble, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Now, stand by me.
Hi.
Hello, how are you?
Not bad, how are you?
I'm doing really great.
Awesome.
I have a question for you. I met you at another convention, and I really didn't know who you were at first because
I am shocked and offended. You may no longer ask a question.
I kind of want to know your story, how you got in. I know you know Jetson.
I was born on a cold night.
I want to know how you got in with Supernatural and what drug you ran with us.
Good question. So, like I said, I was born on a small... I grew up in Virginia. And, when I finished college, I moved out to California, and I would say long story to medium long. I did this radio contest right when I got to town. A buddy of mine took a video of me singing and playing, a guy that I went to college with, and he took a video of me and he sent it into this radio station, and I didn't know. And Ryan Seacrest called me live on the air and said, hey, you're a finalist. And I was like, hey, it's 8 o'clock in the morning, dude. Why are you calling me? And who are you? So long story short, they took us to the finals. They took the final five to Vegas, and we did this big show at the Palms, and we were on the radio, and we did all this crazy stuff. And that was like my first month in Los Angeles. And during that whole process, one of the guys that went to Vegas with us from the radio station was like, you're brand new in town, right? I was like, yep. Because did you move out here with some friends?
And I was like, you're my friend. I have you. He was like, yeah, we're having this, I'm going to this Christmas party. When we get back, you should come. And I was like, cool. So it was at Jensen's house that he was renting with a bunch of other fellas, obviously way before the show. And so he had a bunch of guitars in the corner. And so we ended up sitting in the corner and playing music all night, pretty much. And then Jay was like, hey, what are you doing tomorrow? And I was like, well, jamming with you, I think. I guess that's what we're doing now, because that was all I really had to do. So then when the show came around, he and I have been buddies for a long time, and I've been playing shows for a while, and he and I had sung in a buddy's wedding together. Somebody asked us to sing Crazy Love in their wedding, so we did that. And I think the first ever convention for Supernatural was in England in 2007, and he was telling me about it, and we happened to go out to dinner with his manager that night, and we got chatting about the convention and what was going on and what they were going to do, and I said, do they need music? and she was like, I don't know. She's like, I'll find out what they're doing. So she called the organizer and said, hey, what are you guys doing for the nighttime? And they're like, we'll probably just hire a musician to come in and play a show. She was like, I know somebody. So I went to that convention. I played a set, and Jensen came up and sang with me, and that kind of went viral. And then after that, I started getting invited to these things more. That's the short story. It was still really long. So, hi.
Hi, Jason.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Not bad.
Good
question. Hi. What's up?
So I have another song request, but this one you'll actually know.
You would be surprised at the things I don't know.
No, I can deal with this one.
Okay.
If I could get a kiss, that was a kiss.
Ah. Alrighty then. So, if you guys don't know, I did a Christmas album, and I also did a cover album with a bunch of these guys, Jensen and Rob and Rich and Gil and all those guys sing on. So this is one of those tunes. Should I play the same way I play it on the album, or should I play it a little differently?
If you want to switch it up, yeah, go for it.
You don't have to be beautiful to turn me on. I just need your body, baby, from dusk till dawn. You don't need experience to turn it out. You just leave it all up to me. I can show you what it's all about. Don't have to be rich to be my girl. You don't have to be cool to rule my world. Ain't no particular sign more compatible with. I just want your extra time when you know I'm all about that bass, about that bass, about that bass, no trip. I'm all about that bass, about that bass, no trip. I'm all about that bass, no trip. I'm like all about that bass. Yeah, it's pretty clear, you ain't no size two. You can shake it if you want to. You got that boom boom that all the boys chase. All the right junk in all the right places. Cedar magazines, work in that Photoshop. You know that it ain't real, come on now make it stop. You got that booty booty, just give it up, cause every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Your mama, she told you don't worry about your size, cause some boys like like more booty to hold tonight. I don't want no stick figure sitting on Barbie doll. But if that's what you've got, I promise someone will be right along. But I'm all about that bass, about that bass, about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, bass, bass. Women are girls, they rule my world. I said they rule my world. At your age, mama, not your shoe size, and maybe we could do the twirl. You don't have to watch a dynasty to have an attitude. You just leave it all up to me. My love will be your food, yeah. You don't have to be rich to be my girl. You don't have to be cool. My world ain't no particular sign more compatible with. I just want your extra time and your. I want that booty back. Won't tell the skinny women that. I'm just planning on they think of that. But I'm here to tell you every inch of you is perfect from the bottom to the top. Your mama, she told you don't worry about your side. Cause some boys like me like more booty to hold at night. Don't want no stick figure silicone Barbie doll. But if that's what you've got, I promise someone will be right along. About that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass, no trouble. I'm all about that bass. You don't have to be rich to be my girl. You don't have to be cool to rule my world. Ain't no particular sign more compatible with. I just want your extra time and your. I want the booty back.
I didn't write either of those songs. Just want to let you guys know that. Hi, wait. Hi. I'll come back to you in a minute. Hi. How are you?
Good.
I think I can hear you all right. I'll repeat your question.
My question is, how did you get such a beautiful voice? Aww.
Probably the same way that you got to be so cute. Yeah, I've always really enjoyed singing, so I've just always done it my whole life, and I didn't really think I would do it for a living, but when I went to college, I tried to play basketball, and they said I wasn't good enough to play basketball that year. I thought maybe, I know, right? Yeah. So, if you don't know what just happened, I just got called out in a mean way, but it was awesome. William & Mary is not known for their athletic programs. We're known for our academic abilities, but not so much our sports programs. So when I said I wasn't good enough to play basketball in college, she goes, even at William & Mary? Yeah, so obviously I'm a basketball player I was not supposed to be. And so I started singing in an a cappella group, and that's kind of where I really got to work on my voice a lot and learn a lot. Sing with a bunch of people who were better singers than me, which is, I think, how you get better.
Thanks.
Thank you for the question.
Welcome.
Yeah. Hi.
Hi, Jason. I was online and I found a video of you and Rob and Tom Ellis singing. And I just binge watched Lucifer a few weeks ago. So
right on.
I just thought, how did that relationship come about? Was that at GypCon?
It was at GypCon. These events are so fun because we've kind of created this awesome, fun nest where everybody trusts each other and everybody knows that we all have each other's backs and everyone's best interests at heart. And I think because of that, people have a little bit more bravery when it comes to doing things they might not do otherwise. So I think that's why a lot of these guys get up and sing with Loudon Swain on Saturday night, because they know the crowd is really supportive of them and they're totally behind them, and they know that Loudon Swain's gonna get their back and they're awesome musicians. And so, you know, and since we all kind of have that core feeling, we kind of bring it with us wherever we go. And we were doing an event in England, or Italy, where it was a bunch of us there, but there was also other shows involved in the convention. And one of the shows that was represented was Lucifer. And so Tom got up, sang a tune with us, and you know, we ended up singing with a bunch of guys that weekend. Yeah, it was really fun. But I think they all had a good time too, because there wasn't any kind of like judgment or competition or anything. It was just like, let's jam, let's sing. You know, the crowd will dig it, so let's do it. Thank you. It was really, really fun. Hi.
Hi. If you could collaborate with any musician, dead or alive, who would it be?
Such a good question. I have two answers. One, I actually have like 50 answers, but I'll narrow it down to two or three. My favorite singer of all time is Sam Cooke. So if I could collaborate, and by collaborate I mean stand slack-jawed, unable to say anything while he sings, I would have loved to have done that. I would also love to work with guys who are producers as well as musicians, because I'm kind of starting to go down that path a little bit. Working on those cover albums, I kind of found a love for producing music that's not my own. I had never done that before, and on the Christmas album, actually, it was the first time that I sat with the engineer while someone else was singing and kind of said, oh, that sounds really good, why don't we try it this way, or try it this way, or go here with that note, or maybe bend it right there. I really enjoyed it. So some of those guys, like Prince was a really good writer-producer. I don't know, somebody like maybe Pharrell? I don't know. I don't know, I just think it's such a fun question that, you know, you kind of think of weird combinations and crazy stuff that you could do. But yeah, I'll stick to those three before I just talk for the rest of my time naming random. Thank you. Hi.
Hi. This is a bit of a request. If you could please play another number.
I'm one to see you through. 3 o'clock in the morning, I'm there for you. I'm the one to sing to you. Just another number that I wrote for you. I'm the one to see you through. 3 o'clock in the morning, I'm there for you. I'm the one to sing to you. Just another number that I wrote for you. I won't sell a million letters, 'cause I don't fame. I don't care if no one knows my name. When the sun goes down, I promise you I will be around. You're never gonna have to worry about my love. I'm the one to see you through. 3 o'clock in the morning, I'm there for you. I'm the one to sing to you. Just another number that I wrote for you. I'm the one to see you through. 3 o'clock in the morning, I'll be there for you. I'm the one to sing to you.
You know what my favorite thing in the world is?
What?
When somebody says, hey, can you play that song you wrote 22 years ago? No problem. Got it. That one I actually remember. But some of that stuff from my first album, start playing it and they're like, you wrote this, right? I'm like, I did. I think, a long time ago. Sure did.
I wanted to know if you could share some of that.
Well, we have a lot of squirrels down there, but the moose was... that was a shocker. I don't get many of those in Virginia. I just moved back from Los Angeles back to Virginia because I'm old and married and I have my third child on the way. Thank you very much. So it seemed like Virginia was a good choice. So we had a convention in D.C., and I live about, you know, maybe an hour, 15 minutes south of D.C. And I just kind of threw it out to Jensen and Jared. I was like, hey guys, we're going to be super close. If you guys want to come down for a day off or whatever, you're more than welcome. Knowing with about 80% certainty that they were going to be filming until late on Friday, and then they'd fly in Saturday. And then they'd work Sunday, which is what they always do. And then Jay texted me a couple days before, and he was like, hey, we got Friday off, we're coming. And I was like, all right, you guys know there's 750 people in Bowling Green, and there's nothing to do. Don't care, we're coming. All right, cool. So it's fun. Yeah, we hung out at my house and showed them my fishing pond, and we went up to the only restaurant in town, this little Italian joint called Roma's. And the, you know, 15 to 20 people in there were eating like this. Is it recognizable because they were just city folk? I think mostly because they recognized him. A couple people were just like, that dude's wearing a scarf. He's wearing a beanie and it's 70 degrees. So they, then we got up to leave, a couple of the servers came over and took pictures and stuff. And, I mean, it's the tiniest town ever. I mean, I talked to my mom today and she was like, yep, went into Roma's today, still talking about it. See, I think they're probably going to talk about that for a while.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
What's your question?
My question is, what is your favorite song to sing?
That's actually an excellent question, because I already sang it. So normally I would tell you what it is and then I'd sing it. But it changes from time to time. But right now my current favorite is Stand By Me. It's always been one of my favorite songs, and for some reason I never bothered to, you know, add it to my own set list. And I put it on the covers album, and now I just can't stop singing it.
Thank you.
Thanks for the question.
Thank you. say to everyone who was here just now, well, that's everybody. anyway, that Honolulu is actually on the station breaks album, that kind of version of us doing it. So I don't even know if we have it here. We usually don't. But it's on iTunes and whatnot. All of it's on iTunes, and as well as Jason Mann's CDs and his whole collection is here.
I know you're probably not going to do Hallelujah again, but if you do, it should be Mahalo-luya. Because a good idea is a good idea, Bubba. You know, the Saturday Night Special's coming up tomorrow night on Saturday Night, which is aptly named. It seems to me that in hindsight, you guys probably should have created a live album version of that concert.
Well, we did.
Well, you should burn it to CDs.
We did.
You should sell them here.
Thank you.
We do.
Jason, you're an idea man. I'm telling you, that's why you're pointing into the bayonet.
I'm telling you, we have a CD called the Saturday Night Special. It's all Saturday Night Special live music featuring yourself and Brianna and Ruth and Jensen Ackles.
Yeah.
Jensen Ackles?
Kim.
From the television show Supernatural.
All these people. Oh my gosh. You know, funny story happened at the airport yesterday. Someone came up to me and was like, he saw us in LA too, and he saw Rich and I here. Rich went off to make a phone call, get my bag. This guy goes, hey man, you, the guy that was with you, is he on Supernatural? And I go, yeah, he is. He's like, because I knew it was him. I've seen every episode.
Wait, Rob told the story yesterday. The guy's like, I'm a super fan. And Rob's like, are you? So Rob went to the bathroom and came out in the bathrobe and had a plunger to toilet paper, like, are you sure? So now it's break time, Robbo.
What?
It's time to unplug Mike and recharge him. It's time for the band